Okay, hello everyone. Today we're going to be looking at Photoshop 2018 CC and how we open up and create a new project. So when you first open up Photoshop, on my screen we get the list of stuff that I've recently opened. So on your screen it will probably be blank opening it for the first time. So these are all your recent projects or recent jobs that you've done. On the newer version, we have several different options. You have recent, then you have your CC files, which you can store them in the cloud and then work on it from any location, which is pretty nice. If you're on set and you're doing a lot of shooting and you want to load them up, you can load them up and just put them in the cloud so they're safekeeping. Lightroom photos, these are if you do have Lightroom and you've imported them in, made albums and stuff, you have that option also. So today we're just going to create a new one. So we are going to right here click the button create new. So this will bring up a nice new look now for the new 2018. So right here we have our recent, which is almost like the recent photos here, but it's the recent sizes and formats that you've recently done. So it does come with a lot of presets. So we have the photos, these are all photo presets. It's actually pretty nice because then if you're working on some sort of project and you're not sure what size you're gonna be, then this is a pretty good starting point. And they've included a lot of different templates. You're working on the web, they give you the different web sizes for the different web screens. And mobile, if you're doing a responsive website, you'll have all these presets in here so that you can determine how big your graphic needs to be. And film, and here right here is your typical HD YouTube videos, 1920 by 1080. That's the one I would always use there because it'll always downgrade for you. So we're going to go back and we're going to go do custom 1000 pixels by 1000 pixels. So here's your, let's go ahead and name the title here. That'll be lesson one. And we'll go to the width, 1000 pixels. I'm going to leave it on pixels because that's what most of the projects on the web that you use is going to be in pixels. All your presets are predefined, will be done in pixels. Height, so let's go down to resolution. 300 resolution is for your prints. Like if you're going to print a photo out, you probably want it in 300 resolution. 72 is going to be more grainy when you print it. But for the web, 72 is recommended because you want to keep your file size to a minimum but still look good. So you're going to capture that with the 72 resolution. Same thing here, is that's 72 pixels per inch. So if you do a 300 pixels per inch print, it's going to be nicer, cleaner. Now you could do that for your high def photo websites and stuff. You can do 300 to make it look cleaner, nicer, so when they blow it up it looks nicer, but then you're going to have a bigger file. Same thing goes for the colors. Now for colors, they have bitmap, grayscale, RGB, CMYK, and also lab color. We're going to be focused on RGB today because that's what we're going to do. RGB is your basically your web colors, your red, green, blue. And also the CMYK is going to be your print colors, cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. But today we're just going to be focused on RGB. So over here is your bits. So this is how many different shades. So 8-bit, what is that represented as 2 to the power of 8, it gives you 256 colors and then the shade invariance of those. So 16-bit, 32-bit. Now when you sit there and you do a PNG or something and you're saving it for the web, you could do PNG, you're going to see a bigger file size. So The bigger the number, the bigger the file size. Just keep that in mind. For 8-bit, you should be able to go. When I do a PNG, I usually do it at a 24 PNG because it'll give you a lot more different shades, so you get more detail. So you'll want that if you're doing brush strokes or anything with a lot of different shade and variances, you'll want the 8-bit or 32-bit. But today we're just going to be focused on the 8-bit. So the backgrounds, they'll give you a white, black background, or you can pick your color, transparent, custom. So we're going to do a white one. That's with most logos, like you see up here, your white background. Your transparent is if we wanted to use this and do a without the white background, like on a thumbnail on the in the corner of your video or video title, you're going to want transparent. But today we're doing graphics, so we're going to do a white background. So your advanced options right here is your color profile. This you're going to change if you're working with a specific type of camera, and you want those color tones and everything all set up. Today we're just going to take the basically the default, the RGB default, which corresponds to the RGB color. And same thing with pixels. If you got a certain screen ratio or anything that you're looking at, and like, I don't know. When I do my thumbnails, I try to do them a little bit more high def, so it's on a high def screen. If they watch it on a high def TV, YouTube on the TV, that's what I'll use to make it look nice. But for this project here, for just the graphic, we're just going to use the square pixels. So we went over the different types and all the different details that you want to use when you're setting up your first project or any project, and we just hit create. So that gives us a 1000 by 1000 white graphic, and you can see it over here as our background, white 1000 by 1000. And that right there will show you how to get into Photoshop and start any of your projects. So just stay tuned, come to the next one, and we'll continue going through some of the panels over there, how to set them up, and maybe even go through some of these on the next one. We'll probably stay focused on the panels though, and a couple other different options. So see you then.